wide open, Draymond smoking for helping. And you can see they're amped. And you can see, obviously, Tatum. You can see Udoka pull Tatum, talk to him. Kill these motherfuckers. He's letting them know, like, you turn it around right now. We rate you. Good stuff, boy. And you can see, help wide open to Horford off the penetration. Everything off Tatum and Brown's penetration. Boom. And you can see that they help. Again, now Brown again penetrates. They got to help. Wide open to Smart at the same location, basically. Good hesitation. Got not get baited. And that's open. We rate it. Oh, my goodness, yo. And that's how they came back. Obviously, they adjusted in the second half, especially the third quarter where their defensive principles and it's attacking. Right here, Jaylen Brown's got a seal. If he seals, he gets that ball. He doesn't seal, and it looks like a Marcus Smart bad pass, even though he didn't have the angle. But if he sealed, he just catches and lays. But he didn't seal Steph, let Steph elevate, and Steph tips it. Great defense by Steph. But right here, again, you see how they're attentive? Look. See, Rob Williams is there. No drop coverage. We're high on it. And right here, look right here. Screen, fight through. Great defense by Grant. Oh, my God. And we out. And one, he's a damn son. That's what I'm talking about, boy. Bruh. So what Elite looks like, you see right here on the defense. And right here, you can see, obviously, Steph right here gets the handoff. They switch everything. He reads the screen. IQ by Steph and tries to reverse it. But, you know, Rob Williams picks up on it and then, you know, gives him time to recover. And then now they got to pass to Looney. And Smart recovers because Payton can't shoot. And then Williams is there. And then Looney makes a business decision. I'm not doing that shit. I'm not athletic enough. Let me bring it out. And then right here, you get killed. Jump up, bruh. Slither. My goodness, all it takes is a slithery opening. Half a second, bruh, and they can get a shot off. And Wiggins right here, Pat and Tatum. My God. That's rebound, you know, D sound. And you can see right here, look at this. Grant Williams gets killed. He rolls his ankle on the screen right here, or not, well, the stop on Looney is kind of like a bump screen. In unintentional, look right here, kills him with the fake, with the V cut right here. He gets killed, and then Jaylen Brown uses IQ and switches to Curry, and then Klay gets a slither open because Grant realizes late because he's on the floor, and right there, slightly open, bruh. All it takes is half a second for these guys to catch you slipping on movement. Again, the screen, Tatum fights through, but look at Marcus Smart. He doesn't realize that Green's his man, and he's got to switch onto Klay, and Jaylen Brown's trying to fight, and then Tatum doesn't realize that a screen is coming, and look, wide open. My goodness. You have to be smoking. Dog, that bucket is potent by Klay. Dog, I'm trying to tell, man, Joe, like, this all off miscommunication. Look right here. Tatum doesn't realize that Green, his man, is screening. He's got to go switch it. And then look at Curry wide open. Then he realizes late. Then hits him with a pump fake. Now Brown's got to help. Now pull wide open. Chain reaction. My goodness. We said we splashing. Quit acting like you don't know we could shoot, boy. What are y'all doing? Miscommunication, that's what they do. That's why they run around all day, every day, with screens to get miscommunication. And then, look at, bruh. Another great defense by Wiggins, even though he might have fouled him. But Tatum, that's what you did to KD. You were slapping him on the wrist on the shot. Same thing. Same thing. Great defense by Wiggs. Length to length, and he's playing great defense. Wiggins is saving the day. Great left. See, finally, he killed Curry again. But what did he realize? Let me attack left this time, Jaylen. Let me attack left. And that's what he did. Good way to attack left. Right here. Good switch everything. This is what I've been wanting. Switch everything. My God. Even though he killed him. Great late contest. Beautiful. If they score a majority of their buckets off one-on-one, tip their hat off. They win the game. That's what you're supposed to be doing. But sometimes they don't be switching. Right here. Look at Wiggins could have allowed Poole to switch. But he didn't. He kept following. He kept following and made it a trap. And then now forced that. Look at this. 4 on the clock. Now Jaylen Brown got to shoot it. Bruh. Rebound, you know, D sound. Wiggins has been playing stellar defense. IQ, great pass. My goodness. Boom, boom. He said it's a pool party. It's a party. It's a party. Yeah. It's a party. It's a party. You get a high five. You get a high five. Yeah. He said, I'm here, though. You weirdos. You stupid. What are we doing? Kill. Yeah. You missed that. Bro, that should have been gift rack. Tatum, you got your left hand be weak sometimes, Tatum, though. And then kill in transition. Hey, my goodness, Wiggs, and I'm going to give him the biz. What are we talking about, boy? That boy been putting in work on defense and offense. He's been literally the savior. While Curry's on the bench as well, too. Oh, my God, why Curry on the bench so long? And look what happens. Look, great dig by Draymond. He gets killed. But look at Wiggins right here. Off the chain reaction, looking at me, stunts white. Goes back and cuts off the pass and then comes back again and contests a little bit and throws him off. Pff, rebound, you know, D sound. That's why he missed, because of Wiggins. The little things. He's killing. Wiggins is killing. And right here, look at this. Horford just in the drop. Let him Marcus Smart get killed by Looney's brolic screen. Wide open. My goodness. Rebound, you know, D-sound. Even though he missed that, that's an open look. You can't. It's like they're not applying the same context to Steph to everybody in terms of pull. Travel. In terms of pull and Clay. Look at the defense by Wiggins as well again, too. They don't apply the same defensive principles to that they're applying to Curry, to pull and Clay. Look at this. Look, right here. Kills him. Right here. And then Marcus Smart saved the day right there. But then it's hit with the push off. Killed him. My goodness, man. He said, Clay, come on, man. Like, bro, Marcus is like, that's a push off. And you can see Clay's amped. He's like, it's not game six, Clay, but I'm preparing. I'm preparing. It's game five. I'm preparing. I'm going to heat it up. Right? Kills. And Marcus Smart saved the day right there. And then he got pushed. He got pushed. Most definitely got pushed. He got pushed. He got pushed, though. See right there? He extended the push. If that was Tatum, they would have called it. Anybody else, they would have called it. The refs. That's why Nick be saying they don't need all that cheating. Can't fucking stop me. Clay's amped. What are we doing here? And then right here, trapped. Jaylen Brown. And then, bro, and then right here, this is where the momentum just shifted. All with Steph Curry on the bench. Right here, Marcus Smart gets a technical for talking. That's his first on out. Okay. And he got a tech, obviously. Yo, I'm talking to my team. Like, what's he doing? What are you doing? It's the fucking playoffs and you're going to call the bullshit? I'm talking to my teammates, Tony. He can't come into my zone. He's like, dog, he's coming into my area, hearing me cuss, and he thinks I'm talking to him. I'm talking to my teammates. And then right here, Poole, you can see, baited him. Obviously, pulls his arm. And, dog. And he didn't even hit him. And obviously, that's why Poole looking back like that. And then again, he gets another one. And dog, bruh. It's crazy, yo. You can see this is why Nick Young people are like, yo, the refs are they're cheating, yo. Grab my whole arm. You can see Horford telling him, it's good, yo. Don't worry about it, yo. And you can see he grabs his arm. He's not even looking. And he's like, yo, get out, no, let go. And he didn't even hit him. But obviously, it looked like in real time he hit him with the cell. And I don't did he get fined? I don't know. Look at Poole looking back because he knows he got him. He's like, got him. He didn't even hit him. He actually missed him. But it's all good. You know what I mean? And look, pull up. My God. Boom. He said, we're going to pull up to the pool. We looking cool. What are we talking about, boy? And then Steph Curry comes back in the game. And again, they switch everything right there. Beautiful. And then right here, Steph right here is going to catch you in actions always. Look right here. Back screen. Horford and Tatum supposed to switch. They don't switch. Tatum keeps following because his on-ball screen and off-ball screens are too different. But it's the big. And it now leads to Wiggins on the drop, on the short roll. And hey, my God, that's an athletic left-hand roll with butter. Oh, my goodness, to the goal. What are we? And then he gets trapped. Short roll again. One more. Kill. Okay. Good defense by Payton. You know he has hands. If you've been watching him in the G League from time, he has hands. Steph, are you going to be there? Shoot it, Dan. Oh, no. Canceled the whole break. Steph, what are we doing now? You can't be doing that. It's you. It's you. And then he missed that. That's a great look, though. The pull-up was a great look. He hasn't been shooting a lot of mid-ranges, so he could actually catch them on the middies, but that was a great look. And then right here, again, they want to go to Jaylen Brown. They want to attack Curry, obviously. What are we doing? Attack him then. And then turnover. The hands just be slipping. Like, the ball control has been just fugazi from the Celtics in the whole playoffs period. When they have high turnovers, they rarely win. Like, 18 turnovers. Look at that. Wide open Steph. Miscommunicate. Lucky he's off. Like, he didn't have too many open looks. But he's still, that's the thing. With his movement, he's going to get some. But you want to cancel it as much as you can. Look right here. Look. And then Wiggins, great defense. Great cutoff. Wiggins has been playing stellar defense. And Gary Payton. Them two and Draymond. And then right here, Looney, great help. And one. He doesn't get the and one. Obviously, he got fouled on the catch. But, you know, for the most part, the Warriors are playing great defense. And this is why they went downhill. They started, look at this. Wiggins, mano y mano. Great defense. Great defense. I rate that Tatum. The screen didn't work. He just still didn't go, okay, I can't do nothing. I need to get the ISO. He ISO'd his main defender. They switch right there. But Wiggins got the battle of it. The best of the battle right here. Kill. And then pass. You know, not going to kill. And boom. Wiggins going to kill. Steph, you know, he's not going to kill on ISOs. If it's not there, he's going to relocate, whatever, and pass it. And then it's going to come down to Wiggins. And that's what it's been. It came down to KD. And then look at Tatum. Everything's short. I don't know if it's the fatigue or like when the game just changed with the, you know, with the momentum. How are you missing bare free throws like this? My goodness, yo. Dog, that's when I knew the momentum just changed. And you can see right here, relocate. Off the off-ball screen, not the relocate, but the off-ball screen caught him. That's why you have Draymond. You have the luxury of Draymond, and you can see the fam celebrating. The luxury of Draymond is able to actually pass when he doesn't have to one-on-one, doesn't have to ball handle. Draymond could just pass and give it to me. I'll play make. That's the benefit of Draymond. And you can see he's trying to start some shit, just get in their head. You know what I'm saying? Just let him know we here. We up on y'all. The game over. And that's Game Boy. No Nintendo. As you can see, like, Wiggins played beautifully. Like, Wiggins had a stellar game, and it's not just about, like, this is why, again, if you have the trained eye and you just are a purist and you're authentic to the game and you're not biased, right? People are going to say, I'm a Steph hater. It's not about that. Like, before I even talk about Wiggins, because it transitions perfectly, Steph Curry, like, people overboost the kind of things that he's doing, right? So, like, again, me, I'm just about rating everything accordingly. Like, we understand Steph is the greatest shooter of all time. I'm never going to say nothing about that. I understand he's so elite because he's hybrid. He's literally a combination of the Rip Hamiltons, the Reggie Millers, right? The Ray Allens, but he could also ball handle, and he's doing shot creating shots from the midi. He's doing it from three, from hella far. So he's a hybrid. That's why he's so tough, and he has great conditioning that he just keeps running around, and it's tough to do. As an offensive player, running around, period, it's tough to do. But what happens is why I have a knock against Steph, and this is why he hasn't got Finals MVP to this day, why it's been KD, and Iguodala, and why in certain scenarios in the finals, he kind of like, he doesn't put his imprint on the game that he should do, that he's been doing in all regular season long. Like, it doesn't translate to the same magnitude or in the same breath. It's kind of a big drop-off from what he does, right? MVP, 30 points per game, Curry. You don't see that consistently in the playoffs. Obviously, here and there in the game, but consistently, you don't see that. And there's a reason for that, because the defensive coverages are differently for the most part, especially when you get to the finals. They switch everything. And that's what I'm saying. When you run your actions and, like, you're moving hybrid and you're doing all these actions, no one says don't do it. Obviously, that's what he does. That's who he is. That's why he's elite. He does those actions, and it's a skill in doing that. Don't get it twisted. So it's not a knock. But what is a knock is when they cancel that, when they adjust to it, when the defense is in tune to it, and they cancel it, and they cancel all those actions, what do you do? Can you still have the ability to now ISO when they force you to? And Steph doesn't really do that. Don't let the chart fool you that shows you, oh my God, he leads in ISO. It's cat, because like I showed you, in scenarios where he just used the screen, a guy had to fight through and he's late getting to him, and now Steph does a dribble and escapes or does a step back or whatever and kills off of that, it looks like an ISO, and the stat will read it as an ISO. Because an ISO is probably like, I don't even know the full definition, but it most likely is you taking a dribble with a defender in a close proximity of whatever feet, whatever it is. You have to, you know, dribble or whatever, 5 seconds or whatever window they have. And it's not, there's no context behind it. It's just the same thing like, oh, this guy's a leading dribble pull-ups. No, a dribble pull-up is literally a different type of shot than a set shot. There's two, like, it's cap, right? You have to understand the game and know the game and actually probably have hooped to understand the difference, because you know the difficulty in this type of take and this type of take. This type of ISO and catching this guy while he's, you know, he's kind of in helter-skelter fighting through the screen, and now he's trying to get back and now you kill him because he's not on you. That's why Luka's, Harden, LeBron's, even you've seen Jaylen Brown, Tatum. Yes, getting a screen to get an ISO is not a problem. Getting a screen is not an issue. People are like, oh my God, you hate screens. No, it's not an issue. You can get a screen to ISO a weak defender, but when it doesn't work, when they fight through, he hedges and the screen doesn't work and the primary defender stays attached to you, can you just kill him? If the screen does work, and that's the difference. Those other guys screen to kill an ISO. Steph Curry doesn't screen to ISO. He screens to kill you in gaps. He screens to kill you in miscommunication. He screens to get open looks off of the screen. It's different than screening to get an ISO of a weaker guy. There's nothing wrong with that. Steph don't do that. That's what I try to highlight to people. Like, he don't do that. So don't let that ISO chart fool you. Like, don't let it fool you. Don't let it fool you. Have the IQ. Don't be brainwashed and tapped into the matrix as you see a chart and you see some words. Understand the game. See the footage. Watch. If you get your own footage, you calibrate your own information from what you watch with the trained eye, you'll know what's capping, what's not. You know what I'm saying? Like, you'll know. So that doesn't translate. And you could see a lot. Dizzy ISO, and I'm showing you bare plays. That's why it's a longer video and stuff like that, because I want to show people a plethora of plays. So it's not like, oh my God, you see on like Twitter and wherever you go, even IG, you'll see like a 1 minute clip or whatever of just like cut up plays in transition to try and, you know, mesh together to try and show you like, oh, this is what he does. No, I showed you bare, like consistent plethora, even times where he doesn't even shoot. Because if you go on YouTube and you go type in highlights, you're not going to get times where they pass the ball. You're only going to get times if it led to an assist, if it led to a bucket, or if you go type in all possessions and you get the misses. But it's a shot attempt. There's so many times there's not a shot attempt and he just passed and went to the corner. And then Wiggins had to go to work. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is what I'm trying to show people. So understand that it's not that it's a full knock to Steph Curry. It doesn't mean he's not great and understanding and stuff like that. No, it means that there's still levels to this. Especially when you talk about the Kobe tiers, the MJ tiers, even the Bron tiers, like all these other tiers. These guys, majority ISO for the most part. LeBron's bag isn't deep when he ISOs, but he still ISOs. Harden, that's Harden ISOs. Like even before, even though he's not a lead in the playoffs, he's still ISOs. Luka, you see, it's all pick to switch, and then I walk it out. You're here now. Now I kill you. Steph, don't do that. So that's why in a lot of these moments, and now he's canceled, and a guy like Wiggins, this is why I said it translates perfectly, transitions perfectly. A guy like Wiggins has to ISO. A guy like Wiggins has to kill. That's what happened when KD was there. That's why he got finals MVP. That's why he was the savior, because when those actions are cut off and it's not working, are you just going to ISO? Is Klay just going to ISO? No, he's not. No, they're not. Which is why you see Steve Kerr say, move, move. Like, we got to keep going. Keep all the way to 24 seconds, move, and we catch them slipping and we score. We get stops, we run in transition. That's their game. And it's hard to be attentive to that for full 24 seconds. You see Grant Williams just slip at the last second. Clean, just half a second of a look. Bucket, right? It's hard to do that versus these type of shooters. They're skilled in these actions, which is tough to do because it's different type of shot mechanics and all of these coming off the screen. Right, left, plant going left. Left, right, plant going right. All these different movements is different releases. The release, when they shoot, it might look the same, but how you got to the release, you're leaning. It's different releases, different gathers. It changes your focus. It's like not everybody could do that. That's why certain guys can only pull going this way. But when they come this way, they can't pull. You get what I'm saying? Like, you have three guys on one team. And when you added Jordan Poole, Klay, and Steph, that could do that in those actions. That's why they're tough to beat. That's why I said the Nets were going to be impossible to beat, too, if they had Joe Harris and everybody healthy, right? But the difference is KD had to play make and ball handle and Kyrie as well, too. But KD couldn't just come off a down screen, a pin down with a playmaker passing that. The luxury with Curry is he has Draymond to do that. Draymond is the one who could ball handle and just can just play point forward. That's why Simmons is going to be identical in that role with Draymond, but a 2.0 version because he's more athletic, taller, and he's more aggressive in terms of when he's not going to be in the paint and pass off. He only does that because he was mentally frail and confused because he wasn't in his strength. But he's not going to do that when he's in his strength. When I had the whole pain is mine, like he'll kill. So anyways, that was a tangent. But the point is Steph is not equatable to the Dames, the Kyries, like, in that level, that if you cancel those actions, can they kill you one-on-one? Dame, you've seen him go and have a spiritual experience with a lot of one-on-one. He'll even one-on-one game winner you for three. You even know he needs a three and he'll still one-on-one kill you, knowing that you knew I need a three. Everyone knew I need a three and I will still not get a screen. I'll ISO and get a three. That's tough. Kyrie, same ways. Like, that's tough. Steph doesn't really do that, which is why he gets these lulls. And him killing, oh my God, he killed for four games. What do you talk about? Him killing was predicated on the defense miscommunicating. The minute they don't, the minute they're attentive and they treat him with a proper urgency that he deserves because he's elite, what happens? 7-for-22. And this is what you might see moving forward. This is why I still have confidence in the Celtics, even though Wiggins was snapping and going one-on-one, killing, getting in that KD bag, defensively padding Tatum, for the most part forcing multiple air balls. But the reason why I'm still confident in the Celtics, because when you figured out, you finally hindered Steph, which you could have always been done, because Steph doesn't force you. Like, you know, like I said, like I've been explaining, he doesn't kill off one-on-one where it's like, oh my God, he's unguardable. He's very guardable, but he's unguardable in actions. As a team, when you miscommunicate, if you're not in a string, he's unguardable in these actions. But for the most part, one-on-one, he can be very guardable if you're attentive, and that's hard to do. But when they were attentive, you've seen him struggle. So now if they transition that to game six, right? This is what happened in 5, 6, and 7 versus the Cavs. The exact same thing. They were attentive. They switched everything and they were killing him with Kyrie going to work against Curry on his head in 2016. You started to see bad offense from Curry in 5, in game 5, game 6, and game 7. And he choked in those scenarios. K Love was even guarding him off the switch. Tristan Thompson was even guarding him off the switch. And for the most part, that's what I'm saying. The Celtics might finally implemented that, and they have something to walk away with. Can we rely on Wiggins going one-on-one all day, every day? Can we rely, you know what I mean? Now they have to do is apply that same thing they're applying to the Steph, apply the Clay, apply the pool, force Wiggins to get 40 off one-on-ones. And attack Steph on defense because they do the same switch everything. And when you do that, you have a recipe for success because in all these games, they should actually have won technically 4-1 if they were disciplined. Because they're undisciplined and the Warriors are more disciplined, you know, they obviously have championship DNA. You're not disciplined, so you get turnovers. They kill in transition. Now it becomes what you had a lead is decreased. Now it's an uphill battle. That's why the Warriors have won those last two games. It could have been even 3-2, 3-4-1 for the Celtics if they were disciplined, which is why Adoka was saying that. Our offense, we weren't disciplined. We've been patting them on the half court. Now we're not disciplined. Now they can just kill in transition and come back. That now they're more free-flowing and all that kind of like, you know, that kind of aura where it's like we're tough. Everyone's tight. The pressure is there, decreases, and it's just free-flowing. Now or we can just shoot the lights out. And that's what had been happening in these last two games. So, you know, for the most part, Celtics just have to take what they did in Game 5, the positive things, and apply it. Cut out the turnovers, which is obviously hard to do because Warriors have good defense. But be secure. Don't rush. Don't speed up. You know what I mean? You already know when you attack, they're going to help. You kick the shooters open shots, and you just play. That's your ball movement from the one-on-one attack of a mismatch. And put Tatum in the post more with the baby. Not the baby, but the baby and Steph. So when you do that, turn around, fade, whatever. Like, you know what I mean? And for the most part, you have to be it now. That's what I'm saying. Apply what you apply to Steph defensively to Klay because Game 6 Klay is a thing. Game 6 Klay is real. Game 6 Klay is real. Steph don't have to go off. If Game 6 Klay is there, it's real. It's very real. It's very real. You know what I'm saying? So, like, that's what I'm saying. Those defensive tendencies that you're applying to Steph, apply to Klay. If you don't want to apply to Poole, okay, maybe not him. Even though I think you should, all three of them. But definitely Klay, especially Game 6 Klay. Like, be worried, Celtics. Play with urgency. Don't leave him because Klay's been getting open looks the whole series. He's been bricking, and he has moments where he goes off, but he's been getting open looks. His looks has not been bad. Like, he's been great looks for the most part. Great looks in the drops and stuff. Like, he's getting great looks. So, you know, we'll see how this transpires. You already know. This is the real breakdown. Like, for that IQ, thank you for coming for that IQ. That's what I do. It's the real breakdown. You feel me? Anyways, it's True Talks. It's True Talks. Share, like, and subscribe. We out here. There's no doubt here. There's no drought here. You feel me? I appreciate y'all. You already know. Game 6. It's do or die for the Celtics. I think they could win and force a Game 7. I think they could win that as well, too. Again, you're going to have adversity that you've never seen. They've always win one or lose one, win one. Lose one, win two. Like, they've always bounced back from losing one. This was the first time they've lost two in a row. It makes sense. It's the finals. It's going to be the hardest. You're going to see something you never saw. But if you had Game 7 versus the Bucks, where you won two in a row, same scenario, on the road or home on road, road, home, whatever the case is. You face the Heat where you had to win a Game 7. You thought you were going to face the Warriors. I should have said Celtics in 7. You thought the Warriors wasn't going to be Game 7? Like, if those two teams was Game 7, it definitely, like, it's, you took a tough road. So every series other than the Nets is Game 7. Like, it only makes sense. It only makes sense. So, you know, maybe they win in 7. I still have Celtics winning the series. Obviously, my prediction was Celtics in 6. But again, they're not disciplined enough to do that. Clearly. So I still have Celtics in 7. We'll see how it goes. You already know. I appreciate y'all. You already know, man. Spread the word. I'm out here. There's no doubt here. There's no drought here. You feel me? And I'm out, man.